like me, you probably have a ton of that household cleaner, borax, left over from your last slime making adventure. So what can you do with it? Use it to make your own crystals. I'm Anna, and this is Gross Science. Okay, to grow your crystals, you'll need borax, pipe cleaners, string, food coloring, scissors, a dowel or a wooden spoon, water, a cooking pot, and depending how old you are, parental supervision, because we'll be using the stove, and also borax can be quite irritating, so please try to limit your contact with it or wear gloves if you prefer. So crystals are anything made up of a bunch of molecules arranged in an orderly way. The molecules stack on top of each other, making these very geometric shapes. And you actually probably interact with crystals all the time in the form of salt and sugar. Now, crystals can be made in a number of ways. Many of the gemstones that we love are made when hot lava from Earth's mantle gets forced up through fissures in Earth's crust. As it moves through the crust, it cools and is also exposed to great pressure. And when it hardens, crystals form. Borax crystals, however, form when hot water with borax dissolved in it cools and evaporates. As it cools, the borax will form crystals if it has something to cling to. And for that, we'll use pipe cleaners. I'm going to shape mine into a coil like this, but you can experiment with different shapes. You just don't want the pipe cleaners to be either too close or too far apart. Once the pipe cleaner frame is complete, attach some thread to it so that it can hang in your borax solution without touching the sides or bottom of the pot or heat-safe container. It's gonna need to sit around for a little while, so suspend it from a dowel or a wooden spoon or even a pencil if that works. Now it's time to make the solution. A certain amount of borax will easily dissolve in water, but to make these crystals, we're gonna need to make what's called a supersaturated solution, which means that we add so much borax that no more will dissolve. To do this, boil some water, I'm using about 7 cups, and then add your borax. To get a supersaturated solution, continue adding borax until the liquid stays cloudy. If you want to make your crystals fun colors, now's the time to add food coloring. Then turn the burner off. I'm going to transfer my liquid to a heat-safe container, but if you have a big enough pot, I'd recommend using that because it'll be much easier to clean. Finally, suspend your pipe cleaner structure in the liquid. To make sure that the crystals are able to attach properly, you might have to dunk the pipe cleaners a few times to get rid of any air bubbles clinging to them. Then cover the top with some tin foil. And for the biggest crystals, it's best to leave it on the stove overnight. All right, everyone, I know I said this took overnight, but I actually made some crystals earlier. So, da-da-da-da! Here they are, look how cool that is! This was just one attempt, but I've actually made some others. And you can really experiment with different sizes and shapes, but just remember that these are borax, which can be irritating, so you don't want to handle them too much or use them as jewelry. However, if you seal them with something, you can totally use them as decorations in a craft project or something like that. So please experiment, send me photos of what you guys create, and let me know how you like this experiment. Thank you so much for watching. Ew. Hey guys, one more quick thing. I just wanted to give a shout out to Above the Noise, which is the new show from PBS Digital Studios. Every week they look at a controversial or trending topic like gerrymandering or whether we should ban energy drinks, and they try to cut through all the hype. And if you like Gross Science, please hit that little bell icon, even if you're already subscribed, to get notified every time I post. Thanks.